Chasing a dangerous quarry, the Herald of Darkness. His evil doppelganger, known only as Mr. Scratch.
I'll catch you eventually!
Maybe. But what are you gonna do then? By then, I'll have had my hands on everything you love.
Been brutally spat out from the darkness that surrounds the shores of our reality. He has come to fight a decisive battle in Night Springs.
That again.
In another life, the man was a writer. He still practices that art, forging weapons of war out of ideas. But the violent currents that brought him here have scattered the pages he has written.
My name is Alan Wake, and I'm a writer. I didn't become one overnight. Like most writers, I struggled with it. A short story here, an article there. Then I got lucky and spent a year as a staff writer on the Night Springs TV show. It wasn't the great American novel of my fantasies, but it taught me discipline and craft, and the difference between wanting to be a writer and actually writing.
The lights of the motel promise safety. The man senses that the solution to his predicament begins there. Somewhere within the Earth, space itself has been pierced, and from dark depths runs a steady flow of monsters. The man recognizes the hand of his evil double in this. He knows he must put an end to this madness.
I can't stay here now. It's a little sad how many problems you can solve with buckshot.
Thank you.
To change reality, you nudge it into the right direction. Your version of it is there, waiting. It wants to come true. All you need to do is help it achieve its potential. The devil is in the details. You change the details of the scene to match those on the page. If you get the details right, if you achieve that critical mass, the shift will come, and the rest of your new reality overrides the existing paradigm. The lie, no matter how outrageous, is now the truth.
Hell, this isn't gonna be good.
Is this on? How can you tell? I'm sorry, I'm not very good with gadgets. That's more like it. I'll be right with you. I just gotta do this one thing. I like it quiet. I bet you're wondering why this is happening. Why am I doing all this? Why am I so hell-bent on ruining your life? You're cramping my style. You've got money, fame, everything you could want. But you don't know what to do with it. I do. I'm getting all the things you never had the balls to go for. Having more fun, too. Do you know the real difference between us? I'm not afraid to be the center of attention. This poor slob's just collateral damage, really. I mean, made some information out of him earlier. But this part? This is just for kicks. So quiet.
Well, here you are, about to enjoy another cool Arizona night with me, Eddie Rodman, the host with the boast. Hey, any of you guys remember Old Gods of Asgard? Man, I actually saw them twice back in the 70s. I was just a kid then, but my dad worked at this club, and he'd sneak me in to see bands all the time. You know how it is. Talk about an education. Anyway, great band, couple of great albums, solid fan base, and then they kind of dropped off the face of the earth. Well, now, almost four decades later, they're making a comeback. Let me tell you, these boys have seen a lot of road. They're some serious rock and roll veterans, because they weren't too young even back in the day. Well, now I've got Odin and Tor Anderson, two of the original Old Gods, in the studio with me, along with their manager, Barry Wheeler. Nice to have you guys here.
Oh, hey, great to be here, Eddie.
Yeah, hey.
Hello.
Now, boys, let me just come around and say this, all right? Spring chickens, you ain't. I mean, you guys, you make the Stones look young.
You're only as old as you feel.
Who you calling old? Now, your last album was 1978, In the Valley of My Shadow. And then you stopped playing altogether after that. Why? And what made you do a comeback after all this time?
Well, it was a sad thing. See, the original bass player for Old Gods, Fat Bob Balder, passed away in...
Leukemia! Bob had leukemia, poor bastard.
Yeah, after that, we didn't feel like playing no more.
Long story short, I ran into these guys up in Washington, and it was obvious to me that they still got it. So I figured, hey, let's make some music, right? And they went for it.
Now, Barry, you were a literary agent before this, right?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and you were very successful. You represented Alan Wake, I believe, who disappeared under mysterious...
Yeah, that's... Hey, I just want to talk about old gods tonight. Is that cool? Can we do that?
Oh, yeah, sure. Listen, why don't we take a little break, and then later on in the program, we'll hear the new Old God single. Stay tuned, folks.
Well, at least Barry landed on his feet. Hello?
I know that when I arrive, the clarity of vision I have now may disappear. I've made my plans. I've prepared for this. But I know the transition from the dark place will be hard on me. And not just physically. It may affect my mind, my memory. These pages should help me remember and focus. That's worked for me before. Even if that fails, I think I will be able to trust my instincts. I'm navigating my own story. I'm hoping I'll know where to go and what to do. Even if the details elude me.
I guess it's about time I went full auto.
Hey, it's you. There. You remember me, right? Emma? Emma Sloan?
I think you might have something that belongs to me.
Really?
A typewritten page?
Oh, yeah, that's weird. I did find a page like that. I don't even know where it came from. It was all this weird stuff about the oil derrick and a satellite.
Yes, that's what I'm looking for.
Well, I don't know how you knew I had it, but I guess it's yours. Listen, What's this all about? There are these really creepy guys hanging around the oil derricks. There's something really weird about them.
They're dangerous. I'm gonna deal with them. Try to stay out of their sight, okay? And stay in the light. They hate the light.
At the oil derrick, the wheel had been jammed in place and turned until the oil gurgled and flowed thick and flammable. The warning lights were blinking in a fast rhythm, bright and steady, powered by the battery. The Kasabian CD was playing in the boombox, all distorted guitars and intense beat. High above, some piece of orbital junk or another collided with the satellite, knocking it radically off course. Trailing debris, it screamed down from the skies at an impossibly steep angle. All that high-tech engineering reduced to nothing more than a bullet that would destroy whatever it hit.
Just to be clear, you should know that we haven't actually met before.
Sure we have, Mr. Wake. Remember, you stayed at the motel here.
No, the guy you're talking about just looks like me, even if he uses my name. He's behind all this trouble.
Oh, I thought, now that you mention it, I guess your aura looks a lot nicer than his, actually. I'm very sensitive to things like that.
There's a bunch of stuff I need to find.
The things mentioned on that page? Well, there's a lot of old crap lying around this place.
Great, thanks.
I think you should be able to find everything, except the satellite, obviously. Are you gonna tell me what this is?
I don't think that'd go over too well.
Why don't you let me be the judge of that?
Fine. The page is a formula for rewriting reality. Either I use it to close a strange portal to a place that isn't in our world, or shadowy serial killer monster things keep pouring out of there.
Yeah, you were right the first time.
You can think what you want about me, but there's still bad guys around. Be careful.
Well, you might be nuts, but I've seen the way they move, the way they look. I'll buy that.
They're called Taken. They aren't really human. Not anymore.
And they're climbing out of the oil well? What, do they have secret headquarters down there, or...?
No, that's just where the point of connection is. It's a hole that leads to, well, it's a really nasty place. That's why I need to close it.
And the guy who looks like you opened it, because he was hanging around the oil field before.
He gets around, unfortunately. Thanks for helping me.
Oh, I wish I thought you were just a nutcase.
Actually, I kind of expected you to.
Me too. But I feel like this is how it's supposed to go. Isn't that weird?
Not really. I get that a lot in my line of work.
What do you do anyway?
I'm a writer.
Obviously.
What was that you said about my aura?
Oh, I'm very spiritual, you know. I can see auras, but I only use it for healing and helping people. I'm like a wise woman, you know? I give people insight and advice.
Look, just because I say crazy things doesn't mean I believe everything.
Don't be like that. Maybe you should take a few crystals with you if you're going out there. It might be dangerous. They soothe your energies and focus your mind. It's fantastic.
And they help me take out the bad guys?
Oh, well, no, not as such.
Yeah, okay, I think I'm...
Or I have some wonderfully potent herbal detox suppositories.
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good.
The Champion of Light recognizes the page he got from the woman. It is a weapon of his own design, custom engineered to destroy the dark portal. If he recreates the conditions of the page, a great power will be unleashed.
Wait! Whoa! That's one thing down. Just one more to go.